and he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31.
Evans, the ball carrier.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
A six-yard pickup brings up second and four at the 31-yard line.
Second down at four. Jackson on the give to Downs. And he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Third play of this opening drive as they're looking at a third and three. From the shotgun into double coverage, and it's intercepted. TJ Green with a pick, and they will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20. That's kind of a double whammy. I mean, the interception on the opening drive, that's one thing, but to give him this field position, that's another.
Absolutely perfect start for this defense. They take the ball away on the opening possession. They know that their offense will get the ball to start the second half. They line them up in field goal position, and to me, they got a chance for a touchdown right here out of the gate.
So after the INT, it's Kaepernick. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Yard touchdown grab, and the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead. Point after here coming up, and his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Raiders take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Offense set to get this drive started. They had the auspicious beginning to the season, a first drive turnover. Now they'll try again here, first and 10. That one caught out wide by Boykin. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2.
Complete.
That was a lightning fast decision that time. He just caught it and got rid of it.
Because he saw his guy was going to be open immediately. So he took the R, the run, out of the play. He took the O, the option, out of the play, and immediately got to the pass.
Ahead of the chains now, second and 2. Dobbins running out of the gun. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. 16 yards, a first down.
That's pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at him and let your big horse charge up the middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing fancy at all. Challenging that defense. And on that go-around, the offense won the challenge. Right back to Dobbins on first. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Brings up second and 11 at their 48-yard line.
On second and 11 now. Jackson, a 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. picked off by Eli Apple. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
A quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level.
Ball at the 24 and a second and 11. Shotgun snap now for Kaepernick. Got his man, Robbie Anderson. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. 11 yards there, first down.
Catch there by Robbie Anderson, and we all know he's got the speed to get behind any defense. What I think is underrated about his game is his toughness and his belief in self. Robbie Anderson was an undrafted free agent who's turned into a big-time player in the NFL. And now landing in Carolina reunites him with his college coach, Matt Rhule, when they were together at Temple.
Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. Here's Kaepernick. This one complete to Curtis Samuel. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 25 yards there on the catch and run.
How about a guy proving his worth in different ways? Had the big play in the run game to play before. This time, they go right back to him in the passing game, and he comes through with yet another big play. That's why you work out so hard in the offseason, so you can stay on the field and accumulate big plays.
Kaepernick now on first down, and that is incomplete. Christian McCaffrey, last year's catch leader among running backs, the intended receiver, and now it's second down.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Here's second and 10. From the gun, it's Kaepernick. And he'll dump this off to his running back, McCaffrey. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle comes at the Raiders' 24-yard line. A gain of 13, it's a first down.
First and 10.
Well, they've certainly done a nice job spreading the ball around on this drive. This time he gets it out to his back, and it's another nice play and another first down. They've got the defense on their heels a little bit. They're reacting.
Trying to get it to Anderson, but it's intercepted. Jonathan Abram picks it. And he may want to track down that football because that's interception number 1 on his career.
You're saying that's going into the trophy case?
I'd put it there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. That's when you ask the equipment guys to make sure they hold it for you after the game. But if you play in the back 7 on defense, that's part of your job, finding ways to take the ball away from the other team.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. 2 drives, 2 interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week? Not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
second and 10. To throw again, Jackson. And that'll be complete to Dobbins. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. They get six. That'll leave him with third and four.
Oh, I came to my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big, but in the end, give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a third down.
They face a third and four after that last completion gets him six. Going to have the first down as he's marked down just shy of the 20. Bit of a surprise. They ran it on third and medium. Proved to be the right call. First and 10.
First down, Raiders.
Six nothing, our score after one.
With the score, Panthers 6, Raiders nothing.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Jackson on first down. Man open, that's Calvin Ridley. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35.
To Calvin Ridley.
They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains.
And the Raiders.
That was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. A shotgun snap and a gift to Dobbins. On the tackle there, Natrell Jamerson out of Wisconsin.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver. But he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up three on that carry.
Takes it past the 45 and down at the 46. Call it a gain of five there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with third down coming up.
And it's third down.
Jackson now off the bootleg, rolling to him, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Brian Burns coming in to drop it for a loss of eight, and it also brings up fourth. Here's the Raiders punter now, Christian McCaffrey deep for Carolina. And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down to close to the goal line at the one-yard line. Amazing. Perfectly placed. If that ball goes one extra yard, maybe not even an extra yard, the starting point is the 20.
So there is a reason that a lot of punters are also excellent golfers. They know distance control. You know what else they have? Same groove motion over and over. Once they have that down, it repeats under pressure.
And this will leave them a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
That first down run could not have turned out worse for a defense, because when they came out on the field, their number one mission, keep them stacked up close to their goal line and at worst, create great field position for their offense.
Kaepernick to throw on second down. Open man is Samuel, complete. And he'll get it up a little shy of the 15. They'll spot him down at the 14-yard line. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. On first and 10, here's Kaepernick. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Trayvon Mullen, and he'll bring this one back to the 29.
They'll take
so that's back-to-back drives where they throw an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Made by Kaywan Short.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Working with second and five now. Now a handoff for Dobbins. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. A short gain of just over 2 yards as the first half clock dips inside of 3 minutes.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
And he's going to have a first down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line.
He's taken
a third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll again head down to visit with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando back for another year. He'll have scores from around the NFL here on this opening weekend. On first down, Dobbins. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
It's a pickup.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
On the ground, it's Brody. And he'll find his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards. And it'll bring up a third and 2 more.
And it's third down.
They'll try to run for it with Dobbins. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. And no signs of the field goal unit. They're going for it on fourth down. Take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown.
Complete to
an 11-yard touchdown. And the Raiders have drawn even here. They can take the lead with the extra point to come. He's got it, and they take the lead at 7-6.
Makes the score Raiders 7, Panthers 6.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
They're on the 25-yard line.
You know,
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And now with still more than a minute to go in what's been a tight game, you figure we'll try to see them move the ball downfield.
And remember, they get the kickoff to start the second half, so this is a golden opportunity for them to go down there and put up a couple of sixes back-to-back. What a momentum swing that would be.
Yeah, you might be able to get a two-for-one without ever even giving up the football. Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, second and 10 from the 25. Here's Kaepernick to throw. And the Raiders have got him. Jannard Avery showing his strength and quickness there. A loss of four. Well, it was second long. Now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Kaepernick now on third and goal. Got his target, Samuel. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Able to convert on third and 14. A terrific play call.
First and 10 at the 42-yard line.
On first down, Kaepernick gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays.
First and 10 at the 40.
And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. Down is Kaepernick. And he's got McCaffrey open, complete. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. 12 more yards for him there. It's a first down.
32-yard line.
So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. It'll be a 49-yard attempt from the left hash. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. And that going to hit in the end zone as we restart things here in the second half with a touchback. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. McCaffrey with a first down and more. And down to the 16-yard line. It's a Panthers first down, 17 yards on the play.
And there's a catch by Christian McCaffrey, and he plays a huge role in the passing attack. He's caught over 100 passes each of the last 2 years, so he is a defense's nightmare, because how do you identify him before the snap on every play? Is he a running back? Is he a receiver? Do you guard him with a defensive back, a linebacker? Whatever you do, he tends to have the answer himself and ends up making big plays.
That's complete, right around the 8. And he will take it across for Panthers' touchdown. A 16-yard touchdown. And the Panthers add on to their lead. And he atones for his miss the first time around as this one is up and good to extend their lead.
16, Raiders 7.
kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this carries into the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
Take over first and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
Offense set to get this drive started. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. On second down, a run with Dobbins. And he's got some space here. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. He's making quite a splash here in his NFL debut.
Well, he was advertised as being NFL ready, and both you and I tend to arch an eyebrow a little bit when we first hear that. But I think that they were right about this one.
So it looks like somebody may have forgotten the snap count, and a 5-yard penalty ensues. And that'll set them back 5. From the gun, it's Jackson. He'll look downfield for Waller. Oh, and for the third time, Jackson going to be intercepted. T.J. Green with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
At their own 12-yard line.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Now on first down. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
On second down, McCaffrey. And he's dropped just shy of the 25 at the 24. 12 yards there and a first down.
And there's Christian McCaffrey with another run. Run CMC, as he's known in the Carolina area. Easily the most productive running back in the league last season. 2,392 yards from scrimmage. He's just so dangerous every time he gets the football. Whether you hand it to him, throw it to him out of the backfield, just imagine if they had the guts to let him return kicks as well. This guy is a true triple threat.
Back to the ground on first, it's McCaffrey. And they work this well upfield across the 45. That good for 22 and a first down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they are playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
That's going to set him back 5 yards. Now they need 15 yards on this series after the delay of game. First and 15. Working from the gun, it's Kaepernick. Winds up and lets it go for Samuel. And he'll take this all the way down inside the 40.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. After the interception, here's Jackson. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off at the 35. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to nerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one? Or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
Now, Brandon, that's the way you want to run the football. There should almost be quote bubbles above the offense right now. Bam, boom, biff. That's how they feel good about moving the football.
Kaepernick throwing on second down. That'll be taken in by Anderson. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. 12 yards there and a first down.
Now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
To throw is Kaepernick. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
So much about defending the pass is being able to be right there at the moment the ball gets to the receiver, and he was right in his hip pocket, helping force that incompletion.
And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. Jannard Avery picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
Brings up third down.
Here's third and long. Kaepernick needing a big play to counteract the sack. From midfield, here's Kaepernick. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Jannard Avery getting him once again, his third sack of the afternoon.
Well, this is what happens when you get behind the chains, as people like to say, when you have obvious passing situations, hard to vary it up and fool a defense.
And you hate those situations if you're an O-lineman, right?
Oh, without a doubt, because you just know they're coming, and you never know exactly how. They can be exotic in their blitzes, or their athletic ability just takes over.
Offense set to get this drive started. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive, and also give him a first down. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you, because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. From the 41, Jackson. being chased out left. He's going to take off with it. Jackson always a threat to run. He's got the first down. He was the NFL's leading rusher among QBs a year ago. Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. And going deep downfield for Boykin. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
For Miles,
we've seen that the deep ball's been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Throwing again. Jackson. Jackson hit, and he lost the football. And it's picked up by the Panthers. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line. The defense, they were swarming that time and ultimately got to him before he could get rid of the football and knocked it free.
And don't you feel just a little bit of sympathy for him back there, though? So much going on, so much swirling around. He's trying to find someone downfield. He's trying to move around to find an open target. Sometimes you forget the number one thing, take care of the football.
The Panthers have the first. It's a gain of 12.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
On the ground, McCaffrey. And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
Brings up second and 4.
To throw, Kaepernick. This will be caught just inside the 10. And here he'll get it down to the 7. First catch of the new season for him, and he picks up the first.
First and goal at the 7-yard line.
They'll try to run with McCaffrey. And he'll be stopped up after only a couple of yards as he gets it down to the 5. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
On second down, here's Kaepernick. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. Trent Cannon there to make the grab. And the Panthers add on to their lead. The Panther offense staying put. They'll go for 2. I think all teams probably like seeing that schedule for the first time. Looking at week 1, oh good, we're at home. This is why you want to be home in week 1. They're looking sharp.
And I agree with you totally. That's what you want. But there carries a little extra pressure with that as well, because you and I both know, protecting the home field, winning your home games is paramount in this league. So you go into it, yeah, we want it, but now you actually have to go out and prove it.
That two sides to that coin, and looking like they're going to protect it here in this one. The Raider offense set to get this drive started, and they knew coming in that this would be a tough place to go in and win a season opener, but this has just been a performance, to be frank, not to be proud of here as they trail big in this fourth quarter. The free safety, Trey Boston, there to knock it away.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Under 4 to go now as they come up on second down. To throw again, Jackson. Buying time to his left. And now he's going to use his legs. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Lamar Jackson, such a threat with those legs, able to improvise and get the first.
And the Las Vegas first down.
Jackson on first down. That's complete to his running back, J.K. Dobbins. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
First down, Las Vegas.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 46. Now whistles here, and I believe one of the Raider linemen might have been moving. Yeah, maybe they were coming with a blitz that time, and it caused a jump.
I think if we saw it, you know that they saw it. Might have been a little discussion down there. Bad guys coming. Pick them up. Pick them up. And someone jumped.
Escaping the pressure right, and he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down. I kind of got to give him credit. Another incompletion there, yes, but he's still trying to make plays outside the pocket.
Yeah, he's been hemmed in for much of the game. How about him getting outside there? And that's what you want to see from your quarterback. He's not giving up on this game, so every other player in the field has.
And now here is another interception. Monte Nicholson picks it, and he's just across midfield and down at the 49-yard line. I'm starting to wonder, Charlie, if 5 interceptions, is that the last that we've seen of him?
Well, I think that a lot of people hope that's the last they've seen of him in this game, probably including himself. If this were baseball, the manager would have been at the mound already and asked for the ball, and he'd be in there getting a shower. But in football, you might have to go stand on the sideline and watch the rest of it and see if your backup can do any better.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
And he will be taken down, but a big play there as it comes just as we reach the 2-minute warning.
First and 10 at the 12-yard line.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Shotgun snap now for Kaepernick. This will be caught at about the 5. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. It's a gain of 7, and it's a second down.
At the 5-yard line.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a first and goal. Looks like a jumbo set with 3 times. And he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Panthers, they widen their lead.
Brandon, that touchdown certainly looks like the clincher to me.
Probably a little too much to overcome, don't you think?
I would agree. I say at this stage of the game, that touchdown should seal the fate.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And no return here for Reed. This will be a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in a game like this, and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And the coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on, get it done, and maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
Looking to find a lane, but he can't. Reined in at the line of scrimmage.
No game.
The Panthers turn to their nickel set. Here as they get ready for third down. Here's a give to Dobbins. And they're going to get him down well short of the first as he can only get this to the 30.
Panthers 31, Raiders 7.
remember sleeping with my ribs touched. I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. Now I get it to go.
Over grind game, over time's up. Play my cards, dumb, my hand ain't really no time for luck. Either you got it, you don't. Lie to yourself if you won't. I put my team on my back. Did what I could, what I had. Now I'll be all in my bag.